If you are an active user of social media, I'm pretty sure that you have come across this controversy, the boys' locker room. For the ones who are not aware, let me give you a brief explanation about this entire story. On May 3rd, 2020, an Instagram group which goes by the name of the boys' locker room was caught online spreading obscene pictures of women and passing disturbing comments on them. The screenshots of that particular group got spread through social media, Twitter especially, and the screenshots became super viral to the point where the DCW, the Delhi Commission for Women, started issuing notice to the police department to look into this matter. And immediately the Delhi Cyber Cell Unit of the police department requested Instagram to share the details of the group admin and the members as well. And Instagram responded by sending them the necessary details which helped the police to capture these people. But let us keep this issue aside. Around the same time, a teenager from Gurgaon committed suicide because a girl posted defamatory post about them. The post included screenshots of a Snapchat conversation between two individuals, between the guy who committed suicide and a friend of his, discussing about a sexual assault on a girl. But the guy completely stopped responding to him and he did not show any interest or participation in the sexual assaults, but he apparently took screenshots of this particular conversation and started sending it to friends who were close to him and to the girl as well, warning her that there might be a future sexual assault on her. And immediately after this, it is reported that the guy who was accused was getting death threats and lot of calls which were harassing him, but he tried to prove himself that he was innocent, but unable to cope up with all this pressure, he finally decided to take the ultimate step and took his own life by jumping off his balcony. His family was immediately devastated. They were completely destroyed and it came off as an absolute shock to them. And the father of the deceased went to the police department and urged the police to have a thorough investigation regarding this issue. And soon after they started their investigation, there was a quick turn of events and there were shocking truths revealed. When the DCP of the cyber cell, Anish Roy, stated that the investigation revealed that the Snapchat conversation was not between a boy and a boy, but it was between a boy and a girl. The girl disguised herself as the accused and spoke about sexual assaults on herself. She was using the fake ID of the accused and was suggesting sexual assaults on herself, but apparently as the boy, the other boy who was in the conversation did not reply her at all. He completely showed no interest in the participation of sexual assaults. When the girl was investigated, she said that she had no wrong intentions and she was just trying this act to test the mental strength of her male friend. And the police department reported saying that the girl is a juvenile and her actions were not malicious, so we are not going to file any FIR or raise any complaint against her. The DCP of the cyber cell also mentioned that the first issue, the boys' locker room issue, and the Snapchat conversation issue are two different issues and they got completely mixed up in the controversy of them circulating at the same time around. They both are not connected with each other. However, after the police reported that they are not going to take up any complaint against this particular girl, there were tremendous amounts of eruptions in social media questioning them what would have happened if the genders were reversed. And immediately after this, I saw a lot of memes and posts on Instagram where people were taking out their frustration against this girl whose actions were responsible for the suicide of an innocent boy. I completely understand, and a lot of my own friends were posting stuff like, this is fake, she's a murderer, she has to be charged with murder, and I completely understand where the frustration comes from. It comes out of pure empathy for an innocent boy and his family who is completely devastated right now. But instead of making this video as a plain news report, I thought I'd share my opinion and thoughts on this entire scenario. I completely understand where the frustration comes from. The girl definitely has to face the consequences that she deserves. She and her actions are completely responsible for the suicide of this boy. But let us remember that just because this one screenshot is fake, this one accusation is false, that doesn't mean that this doesn't happen. As men, we might have all witnessed or at least heard about things like this happening in reality as well. Just because this one issue is fake, this accusation is false, doesn't mean this doesn't exist in reality. Just a heartfelt conversation with one of our female friends or a female sibling or cousin will let us know the amount of trauma, the amount of experience that they would have gone in their own personal life. But on the other hand, there are women who use such serious issues and their gender to make false accusations against men. For example, we constantly hear news about the usage of anti-dowry laws against men to have an extortion or a personal advantage. Constantly anti-dowry laws are misused, and this has attributed in the high suicidal rates of married men. Why do this happen? Because we live in a very, very, very judgmental society. It just took one screenshot of these false accusations which pushed an innocent boy to taking his own life, because that's how judgmental we are. Leave the girl out of the scenario. But what about the people who harassed him? What about the people who threatened to kill him? Why were people so quick to judge on him? Why aren't people patient enough to know what had really gone behind the scenes? That is the problem we have here. Most of the people immediately want trials. They immediately want results. But that is just not how the justice system is set up. If that is the way it is set up, everybody who is innocent might get accused of something that they have never done before. For example, let me tell you something which has nothing to do with this. Something from my personal life, from my personal experience. Last year, I got scammed and I lost a lot of money. And in spite of having all the proofs, evidences and documentations, I filed a complaint against this person, took him to the court and even put him behind the bars. But in spite of all that, I did not get my justice. You know why? Speaking from my personal experience, having to work with multiple lawyers and policemen, even though I am a victim, even though I got scammed in business, I did not get my justice. And I don't care if this person is rotting in a prison. That is just how our justice system is set up. The case has been going on for months. It takes so much effort to prove somebody guilty, because according to our system, 100 criminals can escape, but not one single innocent soul can be punished for something they did not do. But with fake accusations like this, it becomes super tough to prove someone guilty, because the law provides everything in defense of the perpetrators to prove themselves innocent. But with fake accusations like this, the real people who are victimized don't get their justice. And that is the reason why things like this frustrates the people who are actually victimized. It is so freaking evil to accuse someone of something that they have never done. It's as equal to committing the worst crime possible, because in both the scenarios, their lives are completely destroyed and the damage can't be undone. A rape victim and a person who's falsely accused of rape both suffers the same consequences. They might be traumatized for life and the damage is just done. It can never be taken back. So I completely empathize with the people who say that she should be charged for murder. I understand that she is completely responsible for the death of this innocent boy. But at the same time, with all this being said, it is also super important to understand that we always stand for the innocent. We be the voice for the voiceless, and irrespective of which gender they belong to, we always should stand for the innocent. And let me tell you something, whenever a rape issue comes up, the majority of the men in this country, all of them unite against this one particular individual who has committed a crime like that. So I think we men are right to hope that all females unite against the girl when she has committed a crime of that nature. With all this being said, I hope you are kind to each other. I hope we always stand for the innocent, and let us all understand that this is not some sort of competition. This is not men versus women. This is just good versus evil.